So as of yesterday, the NFL officially released the schedules of all 32 NFL teams, which means we're one step closer to NFL football. I need Cardinals football back in my life. It's been way too long. If you haven't seen the schedule yet, the Cardinals actually have a pretty difficult one. Based on the Cardinals' strength of schedule, they have the 13th toughest schedule in the league on paper. Obviously though, this doesn't matter as teams are unpredictable and could perform way better than expected or just completely underperform. In today's video, I'm gonna go through the Arizona Cardinals' full schedule and give my thoughts and opinions to each and every game. I'm not gonna give my predictions for games just yet because it's way too early to do that, but closer to the season, I have something planned for you guys. So to start it off, in week one, the Cardinals will travel to Tennessee to take on the Titans. This game should be a good one and will be a true test for our defense. In my opinion, and I might be a little biased in saying this, but I think the Cardinals have a top 5 front 7 in the NFL. And getting to go up against Derrick Henry in week 1 is going to show us exactly what this defense is made of. We all know Derrick Henry is an absolute monster, but if we can shut him down, we should be able to walk away with a win. Now week 2, the Cardinals will have their first home game of the season, and this is a game I actually want to go to in person, and that's against the Minnesota Vikings. This is Patrick Peterson's return game to Arizona, and the Vikings, if fully healthy, are going to be a really solid team this season. I feel like Kirk Cousins gets way too much hate, because if you look at his numbers, he's actually a really good quarterback. I feel like the Vikings are going to be a really tough game for us, as they have so many weapons on offense with players like Dalvin Cook, Justin Jefferson, and Adam Thielen, just to name a few. This is going to be a fun one for sure, and I'm hoping I can get tickets to watch it in person. In week 3, the Arizona Cardinals are back on the road again, and this time they're headed to Jacksonville to play Trevor Lawrence and the Jacksonville Jaguars. I honestly have no idea what to say about this game, as they're a completely different team than they were last season. They have a new head coach, a new quarterback, and actually have some really solid weapons on offense. The Jaguars could be a sleeper team this season, but I feel like the Cardinals should have the upper hand in this one. In week 4, the Cardinals are on the road once again, but this time we're traveling to LA to play the Los Angeles Rams. Fun fact, the Cardinals have never beaten the Rams in the Cliff Kingsbury era, so we're gonna see if this season, if it's any different. The Rams were already good, and this season they got even better as they acquired Matthew Stafford in the offseason. And we already know what this defense is capable of. We've seen it multiple times. The two games we have against the Rams this year, in my opinion, are gonna prove if we're legit or not. The Rams, in my opinion, are one of the best teams in football, so these two games right here are must-see TV. In week 5, the Arizona Cardinals play another divisional opponent, but this time we're headed back to the desert as we play the San Francisco 49ers. The 49ers were plagued with injuries last season and never showed flashes of the Super Bowl team they were a year ago because of this. This year should be a little bit different though, as they got everyone back and healthy. This is going to be another good game, and I think that every team in the NFC West has a legit shot to make the playoffs this season. Every divisional game this season is going to be a tough one for us, so look out for every game. And in week 6, it doesn't get any easier for the Cardinals as they hit the road once again and head to Cleveland to play the Browns. The Browns are a great team and have one of the best offenses if Baker Mayfield is on point. They have the dual threat backfield of Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt and have receiving threats everywhere in Odell Beckham and Jarvis Landry, just to name a couple. It's always fun watching Baker Mayfield versus Kyler Murray, and this year should be no different. This should be an absolute fun game to watch, as it always is with the Browns and the Cardinals. In week 7, the Cardinals should have one of their easiest games at home too, as they play the Houston Texans. Most likely, this team will be without Deshaun Watson, and on paper, the Texans are absolutely horrible. This will also be JJ Watt and DeAndre Hopkins' revenge game against their former team, so hopefully we get to see them both go off. But if Deshaun Watson does play, this game will be a lot closer and a lot more competitive. In week 8, the Cardinals stay in Arizona and get to play the team that made it to the NFC Championship game last season, the Green Bay Packers. Now, we don't know what's going on with the Aaron Rodgers situation, but for this video, I'm gonna act like he's gonna be playing in this game. If Rodgers is playing, the Packers are one of the best teams in football easily. They have an elite defense while also having the league MVP on their team. This is gonna be a tough one like the majority of the game so far, but at least we're gonna see how good this team really is early on. In week 9, the Cardinals are headed to San Francisco to play the 49ers once again. I already said it, but this team back at full strength is gonna be scary, so don't expect these games to be easy. Now headed to week 10, the Cardinals head back home to play a team that seems to always have our number, the Carolina Panthers. For some reason, the Cardinals always struggle against Carolina, like I don't get it. Whether it's in the playoffs, the regular season, it doesn't matter. The Cardinals always seem to lose to them. Hopefully this year is different though, and we can take them down. They have a new quarterback in Sam Darnold, so hopefully they go through a little rough patches and Arizona can come out on top. In week 11, the Cardinals hit the road one final time before the bye week to play the Seattle Seahawks. Again, I've said it multiple times, but no division team will be an easy win for us. We seem to always split the series with the Seahawks anyways every single year, and I wouldn't be surprised if we do it again. The Cardinals always seem to win in Seattle, and the Seahawks always seem to beat us in Arizona. It's so weird. You'd think that home advantage would help a little bit, but in this instance, it literally doesn't. This will be a great game, and hopefully we can walk away with a win heading into the bye week and end off strong. Now, before I go any further into the schedule, let me know down in the comment section below what you think our record will be and why. I love hearing your guys' opinions, so make sure to let me know down below. But back to the schedule, the Cardinals will hit the road once again right after the bye week, and this time we're headed to Chicago to play the Bears. This is just my opinion, but I think Justin Fields will be starting by this time, so I have no idea what to think. I've always said it, the Bears are a quarterback away from being a Super Bowl contender, so we'll see how their quarterback is this season. That's really going to determine how good they are this season, and it makes it really difficult to predict how good they'll be. But with that being said, I do think the Cardinals have the advantage going into this one. Now, heading into Week 14, we have another difficult game as we head back home to Arizona to play the Los Angeles Rams again. Like I said earlier, we have not beaten the Rams under Cliff, so we're going to see what this team is really made of in our matchups with the Rams. Obviously, though, I'm hoping for a different result this season. I gotta see the Cardinals take out the Rams. Heading into Week 15, we're back on the road again and actually have one of our easier games against the Detroit Lions. The Lions are going through a rebuild with a brand new head coach, so we should be able to walk away with an easy win. Or at least I hope so, because, you know, if we lose to a rebuilding team, I don't even know what to say. Now, this next matchup might be my favorite game of the year right behind the Vikings game, and not based on who we play either, but based on the day we get to play it on. We get to see the Cardinals play the Colts at home on Christmas Day. Everyone loves Christmas, and what's better than watching your favorite team play football on Christmas? Getting the win. The Colts last season were a really good team, and this season they have the potential to do it again. The Colts season pretty much falls on the shoulders of Carson Wentz. If he plays great, this team could make a deep playoff run, but if he stinks, this team is going to struggle. Let's just hope for at least this game, Carson Wentz stinks and the Cardinals walk away with a win on Christmas Day. Going to Week 17, the Cardinals are going to be heading to Dallas to play the Dallas Cowboys. This is a team that is super hard to predict as well, but every single year they always seem to underperform. Hopefully that's the case again this year, and the Cardinals get to walk away with an easy win. The Cowboys' defense is awful, and we saw what Kyler Murray did to them last season, so hopefully he can do it again. And for the final game of the regular season, the Cardinals head back home to play their division rivals, the Seattle Seahawks. I said it earlier, but the Cardinals always lose to the Seahawks at home, but hopefully this year is a little bit different. It's time to turn things around, and to end the season on a high note with a win would be amazing for this team. This will be the final game of the regular season, but hopefully that's not the end for us. Hopefully we can make the postseason and maybe even make a run at the Super Bowl. But looking at this schedule, it looks like every game is going to be tough, but we have the squad to go out and compete. This is going to be a fun season, and I can't wait to see what this team is capable of. But that's going to wrap up today's video. If you guys did enjoy, consider hitting that subscribe button. I post NFL and NBA content, so if you're a fan of either of those, this is the perfect channel for you. Also, make sure to let me know down in the comment section below what record you think the Cardinals are going to finish with and why. Also, let me know how far you think this team is going to make it. Do you think they're Super Bowl contenders? Do you think we're going to make the playoffs? Do you think we're going to miss the playoffs? Make sure to let me know. But that's all I got for today's video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. It's been your boy Mythic. Peace out.